Oh my gosh, this has never happened before. I'm sorry, I didn't realize I was muted this whole time. Welcome everyone. Today I'm going to be doing a iris illustration to be a companion for the daffodil illustration that we did last week. I'm just going to get that reference real quick, and then we can start. Wow, they're so beautiful. So many options, it's difficult to pick a reference. I think I found the one, everyone. Just a moment. That's a shame. Shame that didn't work. I should have done it beforehand, but you know, you live, you learn. Just sketching in a pose here for our lovely character. I haven't decided yet if I want to do a more masculine or more feminine style. But we'll see. I don't know. I'll keep working on the sketch and see if I get any inspiration as far as character design. The sketching is always the part that takes the slowest, but you know, you need to get the expression right in the figure before you can start working on the clothes. Mishmashy, hello, good to see you. It's been pretty slow today, but that's all right. It's given me time to set things up and get ready. What am I sketching? I'm sketching the base for my iris design. Since I did a daffodil last week, I thought it would be nice to finish the set and do a... Or since I did a daffodil last week, it'd be nice to finish the set and do an iris this week. So yeah, this illustration is inspired by an iris. Oh, I'm glad you think it's cool. I need to sharpen this pencil a little bit. Can you believe it? I still haven't found my pencil sharpener. Who knows? Maybe this'll just be how I sharpen my pencils from here on out. I'm not one to complain, but it definitely does make things a little bit more of a challenge than it has to be. Alright though, I'll manage. Yeah, it is old style sharpening, isn't it? irises have a very thin stem to them, so I'm trying to design a character that reflects that thinness. I knew something about the proportions was bothering me. There we go, that's better. You know, it wasn't intentional, but I am getting a more masculine feeling out of this design, so I think I will continue leading with this more masculine body type. Mishmashy iris inspired masculine design sounds interesting. Yeah, well, I don't know, they just are such tall, regal plants. They remind me of a gentleman in a lot of ways. Speaking of gentlemen, that's a good idea. I was unsure about what to do with this arm, but I think I like it tucked behind his back. Yep, that's a nice design there. It's a bit of a challenge coming up with something that is inspired by a flower, but is also masculine. I think that's part of the fun, though. Getting this face right, it's been tricky, but I'll get there. Now it's time for some more old style sharpening. There we go. Thank you. Sorry, it's a pretty quiet stream today, guys. I just want to focus on getting this done so we can get to the fun part with the colors. Just playing around with what collar shape what type of clothing did I design for him? Well, I have some bell bottoms with a flare here at the bottom to sort of represent the sleekness of the petals. And then, or the fullness of the petals, these pants are quite tight-fitting because the stalk of the plant is very slender and I want to embody that. And then I've got another sort of, it's a fancier version of the tails on a tailcoat that's sort of gathered and flared to match the petal motif of the bell bottoms, and then I have a dress shirt underneath a tight-fitting waistcoat to embody that sleek feeling, and then I have a flare at the cuff to again simplify the petals. The only thing I'm struggling with is the collar. I don't know what I want to do with the collar. Everything else is great, it's just the collar that's giving me trouble. Could do no collar, but the issue is this shirt I have underneath in all other ways looks like a dress shirt, so is it, I guess it could be a really low-cut V-neck underneath, but I'd have to indicate that. I could indicate that by having it have a drop shoulder. That's it! I could give it a drop shoulder and then... I could give it a drop shoulder, and then... What do we think about that? I kind of like it. It mirrors the, I like that. It mirrors the gloves in the, daffodil design. Let's see, do we want to add anything else? No, I think that's good. Let me just go over the lines that I want to keep sharp. That's the sketch. I keep messing with it because something's just not quite right. Excuse my head. Just gonna give this pencil a final sharpen. There we are. Does his head look too big? I feel like his head looks too big, but it also might just be in my own head. It's gonna bother me if I don't fix it. Bit of a perfectionist sometimes. You got me there, Mishmashy, but sometimes that's okay. It's important to know when to let go of something and when to accept that it's not going to be perfect, but at the same time, it's also important to know when you know something will bother you and to take the extra time to fix it. Where this only took a couple minutes for me to fix, but I'm so much happier with it than if I had just said, oh, it's good enough. So I think that's something important to learn about yourself and whatever it is you're working on. To know when something is worth putting in the extra effort to make it exactly how you want it. And when you just need to let go of the need for it to be perfect. There! Oh, that looks much better. Just mixing up the base wash of paint for this piece. Thank you. I spent a bit longer than usual on the sketch, but that's okay. It's given me time to decide what I want to do for the color palette, so the painting should go quicker than normal. And even if it doesn't, sometimes spending a little extra time on something that you're passionate about is the right thing to do. That dry, and in the meantime, I'll have a cup of tea. If you have any questions about my design process or the sketch in general or anything like that, now's the time to ask, and I will do my best to answer. Mishy-mashy, how do I come up with my ideas? Well, it depends. It's a very subjective thing for me, where certain inanimate objects or abstract concepts will be linked in my mind, and I get my inspiration through that, for the most part. For example, because of how thin they are and how tall they are, irises have always reminded me of, like, a slender, stately gentleman who's out in the garden wooing all the other lady flowers. So when coming up with this design, I knew I wanted something that was slender and had a more masculine feel to it, because that's the abstract concept that comes to mind when I think of irises. And that's just an example, but I think if you familiarize yourself enough with your own mind, you'll see that you have your own associations with completely unrelated things, and those are a great source of creativity, at least for me. Thank you. I'm using the same cup and saucer as last week because I don't own any iris or even purple themed teacups. So I thought, well, this is the partner for the daffodil design, and wouldn't hurt to use the daffodil teacup again. And besides, it's still March, so I can still use it. what kind of tea tonight? It is a cinnamon licorice tea again. It is delicious. Sweet and spicy. I couldn't imagine a more comforting tea. Yum indeed, it is delicious. It's so relaxing. I'll never get over tea time. It's my favorite time. It does. Waiting for paint to dry does take a long time. But it's part of the process. You have to embrace it if you want to make art, and I try my best to find it relaxing. Oh, speaking of which, I think it's dry enough to start working. Going to start by just throwing down a lovely skin tone for our dapper gentleman here. I always like to start with painting the skin because even though it's not necessarily an essential part of the piece, it's almost always the part that's the most sensitive to the wetness of the pigment. So I like to make sure that I get everything mixed in the way that I like it before anything else, because then I don't have to worry about it for the rest of the piece. Man, there's nothing like a bit of variety in color to just bring life to the skin. Maybe part of the reason I do it first is because it's also my favorite part. It just breathes so much life into the piece. Looks like living, breathing skin, and it's just so beautiful. I promise I'll stop gushing over it soon, but I think knowing what parts of the design process are your favorite is really good for work ethic. because then you know how to pace yourself and say, oh, well, if I just get through this part and this part, then I can do my favorite part. Well, now that that's done, I'm going to move on to some other pieces of the piece. Let's see, for the pants, I want a medium sort of purpley color that fades into a warmer color at the bottom. Now what I'm doing here is, I'm not necessarily disliking this color, I just want it to be a little lighter. So I'm going to add more water to it and then paint over it again. Much better. And I'm just going to slowly mix in more purple. You love purple mishmashy, that's wonderful. It's a very regal color. I'd say it's second only to pink in how much it's associated with girls, which I think is such a shame because, I don't know, I think anyone should be able to wear any color they want, so to have people say, oh no, you can't wear this color, you're a boy, or oh no, you can't wear this color, you're a girl, is something that's always been very sad to me. Purple's your favorite color? Well, I have a feeling this design's going to be for you then. You like the purple bell bottoms, I'm so glad. You know, if there's one thing I hope makes a comeback, especially in men's fashion, it would be bell bottoms. I mean, this design may look a bit out of the ordinary, but I always felt so sad that men don't really have much in the way of unique designs in their, fashion. I mean, there's definitely some things that are unique, but It's pretty standard, you know, you have a suit, you have a tie, button-up shirts, dress pants. So I think even just the little flair that men's pants used to have back in the 70s with the bell-bottoms would be a welcome reprieve to clothing now. That's all just personal opinion, of course. And don't worry about the blotches, I will fix them. Once I get this gradient blended out the way I want to. Still a bit too much of a line, so we'll fix that. Right there. I like that. And now while that's drying, I'm going to paint the waistcoats. Oh, you agree? I'm so glad. I think everyone should be free to wear whatever they want, but there's just a lack of options or promotions of diversity in pop culture fashion, and that makes me a little sad. I'm just painting around these buttons now so that when I come in with my bigger brush, I won't need to get nearly as close to them as I would otherwise. Now let's do the rest of it. I can change that as a designer? Yeah, and that's exactly what I want to do. So even if my designs seem a bit wild or unrealistic or like difficult to imagine who would wear it, I still want to make those designs because without designers being bold and daring to make interesting designs, things will just stay the same, and I guess there's nothing inherently wrong with that, but I just hope that through my designs, people feel the feel that they have options, even if they don't necessarily like my design specifically, to realize that there are other designers out there and other ways of dressing out there. And you don't have to fit into any one mold. You can have different styles, and you can dress however you want. You don't have to follow trends or designers or anyone. I think too many people feel limited by their clothes instead of limitless. You love the idea of limitless? I'm so glad to hear that. And you know, with limitless possibilities, you still can choose to have very, I don't want to say average, but very standard clothing. And that's wonderful, I think that's fine. It's having the possibility that's important to me, you know? You can have all the possibilities in the world and still choose to wear just a t-shirt and jeans, but it's having that option. It's having the option to choose if you want to wear something fanciful or something a little more functional or something that's both, that I think is so important for people to have. And I'm changing my mind on this color. I was going to do orange, but it blends in too much with his skin, and it makes the design read unclearly. So I'm going to do a more yellow color instead, with just a touch of that original orange I was going for. Too warm, but the right idea. You know, it's interesting. The flower references I've looked at for this create gradients between contrasting colors so easily, and I'm here struggling with it. It's just a reminder that whatever we create, nature will always not only have already created, but will have created in a much more, in a much better and effortless way than anything we could even attempt to make. I think there's a lot of people out there who don't like that, who think, oh, it's so unfair that we'll never be as good at something as nature, but I think it's a wonderful thing to see something that is just in its essence so perfectly suited to whatever it does. I just want to add a bit more of this orange to the gradient I have going on down here. Oh yeah, that's nice. Colorbug, hello, welcome. It's good to see you. We're making an iris look to be a complimentary partner for the daffodil last week. Artsy art, barbecue bacon burger. Oh, that sounds delicious. Oh, welcome, welcome. Good to see you all. Oh man, you're gonna make me hungry, all this talk about a barbecue bacon burger. Oh no! I'm sorry to hear that. I wish there was more I could do, but I think I should stay out of whatever's going on. Best of luck, though. Thank you. Oh gosh. I'm glad you guys are having fun. Well, I don't know what your guys' opinions are on barbecue bacon burgers, but I think one of them sounds delicious. Like, can someone send one to me? Because that sounds delicious. Although, you know, I can't remember the last time I had bacon on a burger. Thank you. The sketch took a lot longer than normal today, but I think it was worth it. I haven't decided what color to make his hair. If anyone has any suggestions, please let me know. There's a lot of color going on in the composition already, so I'm worried about adding too much. Oh, thank you very much. This is a little gonna be exposing myself here a little bit, but I don't know how to draw straight hair very well. I can draw every other hair type, but whenever I try and draw really straight hair, the character always comes out looking like a greasy little weasel. So I tend to just always draw the same sort of same sort of wavy hairstyles on all my characters. Quite a nice color. So I think I'll use this for the hair. It's nice and neutral, but it goes with the piece. The light purple does give it cotton candy vibes. This is nice. It looks a bit more purpley gray on camera than it does in person. In person, it's a sandy brown color, but you know, that's okay. that's drying, I can, I think I can start inking some of it. It's always the balancing act between getting enough done and letting paint dry. But I think we'll get it. I don't know how I feel about the white buttons. I think I might make them yellow or this sort of taupey orange color in the rest of the piece. Problem for future me, not current me, so I won't worry about it. Does anything else need? Oh, right, this shoe needs this color as well. You know, I was just saying earlier, but I'll say it again. I think we need to bring back bell bottoms for men's fashion, or really just fashion in general, but. Guys especially, I think, look nice rockin' wild pants. I'm so happy you like the ombre. If it hadn't been for the prompt I'm using today, I don't think I ever would have chosen to blend these colors together, but I really like how it turned out. You want a pair of these bell-bottoms, Mishmashy? Yeah, you know, I can see why. I think they're a very nice design. I could definitely see incorporating this into, into a fashion line of mine. There we go. Well, while that's drying, I'm going to start with the inking. Thank you. time to add the final little pop of color here and then finish up with the inking. Oh yes, the yellow buttons are much better than the white ones. I just realized this whole time I forgot to paint the proper color on his shoulders. Not a big deal, it's easily fixed. That part is still a little wet. It looks dry. I'm looking forward to showing off the finished work. Good to see you. Yeah, the stream is going pretty well. Thanks for stopping in. Mostly just waiting for things to dry now. Thank you. just concentrating on doing the final line work. Let me see here. Here's the final piece.